In a primetime address last night, President Obama announced his plans to issue some controversial executive orders on immigration reform.
The president spent about 12 minutes arguing an emotional case for why he's making the most sweeping changes to the nation's immigration laws in more than a generation, acting, of course, without the consent of Congress.
Today, local and state officials are weighing in on the move. NewsChannel 9's Micaiah Thurman joins us now with more. Micaiah.
In Chattanooga, Obama's immigration action gives hope to many. But today, one local advocate tells me that they're not celebrating just yet. President Barack Obama will shield about 5 million undocumented immigrants from deportation.
All we're saying is we're not going to deport you.
Hundreds of families and immigrants' rights activists like Netchie Lopez cheered across the Tennessee Valley as President Barack Obama announced his plan.
It's going to be a relief for many, many, many people.
For over a decade, Lopez has managed Latin America Consulting Company. She also works as an advocate for Latinos in Chattanooga.
It's important because they came here to look for a new opportunity, and they left their country sometimes because of the violence in their country, especially Mexico, Guatemala. They cannot go back there.
The announcement, as expected, drew quick criticism from some local U.S. Senate Republicans. Tennessee Senator Bob Corker says President Barack Obama is blatantly ignoring rule of law by acting unilaterally on immigration. In a statement, he says, quote, "This decision makes it clear that the president doesn't have the ability and willingness to lead by rolling up his sleeves and doing the hard work to reach a consensus that is in the best interests of our country." While the move has vast implications for millions of individuals and their families, Lopez says this move is just the first step in the fight for a comprehensive immigration reform. A News Channel 9 crew has also just met with Senator Corker. Coming up at 6, you'll hear more on why he says he's outraged by the decision. Calvin.
Thanks, Micaiah. Today, one member of Congress says President Obama is overstepping his powers after last night's immigration announcement.
Steve Nannis-Nanz has the story.
Nation of immigrants.
One day after President Obama announced plans to make changes to the immigration system by executive order, Republicans are firing back.
We will not stand idle as the president undermines the rule of law in our country and places lives at risk.
House Speaker John Boehner says the president is overstepping by bypassing Congress.
The president has taken actions that he himself has said are those of a king or an emperor, not an American president.
Boehner also announced Republicans have filed a much-anticipated lawsuit against the president's health care law. Last night, in a primetime address, President Obama laid out broad changes to what he calls a broken immigration system.
The actions I'm taking are not only lawful, they're the kinds of actions taken by every single Republican president and every single Democratic president for the past half century.
The White House plan will offer work authorization for up to 4 million undocumented parents of U.S. citizens or legal permanent residents. It will also crack down on illegal immigration at the border. In his address, the president left the door open to a bipartisan deal.
I want to work with both parties to pass a more permanent legislative solution.
But, at least for now, that door appears to be slammed shut.
Actually, the president has chosen to deliberately sabotage any chance of enacting bipartisan reforms that he claims to seek.
In Washington, I'm Steve Nannis reporting.
We will continue to follow what's next for immigration reform.
And you can find more on this story on our website, newschannel9.com.